This is just a temporary flower path while the Paul J. Senior Botanical Garden takes shape. Eventually, it will look something like this model, and the whole project will require a lot of water to thrive.
Last year's drought made a big impact on our thinking, and because of the drought, we've decided that we want to use a very efficient system, and drip is the logical way to go.
These white pipes show where the underground irrigation is buried. It will be a drip watering system for the formal flower beds.
It's just saturating the soil where it needs. You're not throwing water in the air, and of course not losing any to evaporation. And in some cases, you can even bury the drip tubing underneath your mulch layers.
Well, lawns can soak up a lot of water, especially when it is so dry. So folks at the garden are testing out a new product. It's an irrigation mat that's going to go underneath the ground and just below the turf. And this is going to help wick moisture up into the soil.
Still, Lassane says large cisterns underneath the parking lot will capture even more rainwater. Then there are plans for a living roof of plants, which will reduce energy costs in the horticulture building. And once most of the flowers are established, watering will be less frequent. Michelle Kennedy, WXII 12 News.